I'm Solveig. Here you have my contact info. I use free software and especially Debian since quite some time now. And I also contribute to Tails, so my interests are in privacy. Okay. No? Yes? Do you hear me?
Yeah, perfect.
Okay. So, I do some non-developer things, and in Debian I found a way to contribute without coding or maintaining packages, which is to triage bugs. So, bug triaging, it helps. It's like a, it's kind of non-visible, but it helps Debian as a whole because maintainers don't always have the time to deal with all their bug reports. Some packages have a lot of bug reports, like the kernel or Xorg. Also, it's a good way to improve the package quality. So when the some packages have a lot of bugs open against them, it can make it harder for the maintainers to know which ones are solvable, actionable, and they can get a bit over their head. So when you triage bugs, you help everybody have a better experience with Debian. So, you want to do it. First, it's easy. You don't need to learn any new tool, supposing you already know how to read and write email. So that's low threshold to start. It's very rewarding. The maintainers are happy when you help them, even if you don't touch their packages, just if you sort some their bugs, they'll be happy, and the users who submitted them will be happy that somebody looked at them. So it can be very joyful. Also, you search random bugs for packages you don't necessarily know, so you learn about a lot of software in Debian, and some of them are really, really surprising, and you, well, what does this do? And that's kind of fun. And of course, it saves kittens. So. So on this page, there's a, so the bug triage page is a how-to page I made some years ago with tips. And this part especially has a list of teams that added themselves so that they want you to help sort their bugs. So those are the teams I worked with. They're really, really nice. They don't bite. They will let you know if you did an error. They will answer your questions. You can work together. I don't recommend closing random bugs. Like, if you go and touch packages from people you have not warned or who are not willing to have somebody touch their bugs, you might have backfire. So to start, I think it's good to go to packages that you know people are happy if you help with. So another, so the first tool to triage bugs is a UDD. I don't know if you've ever tried it. The interface is really great. I can show you. Here, that's the UDD. So it's a bit arid like this, but it allows you to select distro. It allows you to select many, many types of packages. We can see that later. Then you can choose a team or other criteria. And then when you're happy about your criteria, you search. And it will give you a list of packages corresponding to your criteria. And you can select what some more info you want listed here. So that's UDD search. So I usually ignore the bug reports that somebody has touched in the last year. So probably somebody else will look at them. Let's look at those that are lost in the limbos. I select won't fix, more info, upstream, or unreproducible. So those are those that probably you can do something on. And then you choose a team, preferably one of those that is listed in the page we saw before. So, once you'll have selected a bug and something to do on it, you'll have to document what you do. Because you can change many, many stuff on the bug, you send the commands to control, but it's always nice to put a small sentence or two or three to say what made you conclude that is the right change. And so that, so also make sure the email where you do the commands is sent to everybody interested, because by default it only sends it to the maintainer and the submitter in some cases. So if other people answer the bug report saying, hey, I have the bug too, or if the upstream came by to explain something, it's good to see all of those who interacted on the bug report and put them all in copy. And ideally, people can receive the email, read what you're saying, and don't have to go back to the bug page to read it again. So that you should sum up the thread if it was long and have them know everything. Oh, thank you. If you do massive triage, you should have a few generic messages. So you keep the messages and just replace the words as needed. It saves you a lot of time. Also, it allows you to put a lot of nice things in your generic email that people are always happy to read without more effort. So, you know, they add a little, thanks for submitting the bug, or that was very interesting construction discussion, or something like that, so that let's keep the positive energy flowing. So, there are many ways to triage. One of them is trying to reproduce bug reports. So in the UDD we saw earlier, if you select unreproducible, those that don't have the tag confirmed, these are bugs that one person submitted, but nobody knows if they're really still up to date or if it's just somebody submitted it, but if it's confirmed, there's more chance that the maintainer will look at them. So if they're really old, maybe they have been corrected and nobody bothered to close the bug. If they're new, maybe you should have them too, so see if it's the case. So if it's the case, you write to this address, so the NNN is the number of the bug, and you add the tag confirmed. So that's how we interact with the control at Debian. So the all the bug tracking is on a email interface. So found bug number, version number. So you, that's a command that the control will recognize. So you give the bug number and what version you're running. You add the tag confirmed, since you found it, so you're two, so it's confirmed. And thanks. You always have to end your emails to control with thanks or thank you or whatever variation of it you want. The control is a very, very polite beast and likes you to be the same. So if you don't put the politeness, it won't work. Actually, it's to tell them the comments are done, but let's be polite also with machines. So, if the bug was not confirmed, so you tried to reproduce it and you couldn't. So you could add the tag unreproducible or more info. So depending, if you're quite sure that it, if you're not the first saying I can't reproduce it, or if you're sure you have exactly the same setup as the original submitter, then you should put unreproducible. If it might be reproducible for other people but just not you, then you should ask more info so that the original submitter gives more details on how to reproduce their bug. And it also requires you to be polite at the end of the command. Another very useful thing is to forward them upstream. So some upstreams follow the Debian bug tracker, but a lot of them don't. So maybe somebody reported the issue in the Debian bug tracker, but upstream is not aware of it. And most Debian maintainers are not gonna solve the bugs themselves. They're more probably gonna wait for it to be corrected upstream. So we need the bugs to go back to where it will be corrected. So, yeah, and in a lot of cases, it's also, it can be because upstream considers it not a bug, so won't fix it. So let's say it on the Debian bug too. Or maybe upstream is not aware of the bug. So, okay. Yes. Okay, that's very tiny. At least you have all. So here you have the command to add the upstream bug tracker's number. So forwarded bug number, you put the URL in the upstream's bug tracker, and then you say thanks again. So, yes, so that's what I was saying before. So you can also report it upstream if it hasn't been already. Sometimes the upstream bug tracker is more up to date, so in upstream it's fixed. So it's good to let know to the Debian bug tracker and say add the tag fixed upstream. And it's good to be to say in which version so that we the maintainer maybe motivated to update to the new version. So, in a lot of cases, the bug reports are tagged more info, which is somebody said it doesn't work, which sorry for you, but there's no chance it's going to be fixed with that. So in lots of cases, the bug is tagged more info to say, this bug doesn't give enough info to be solved. Or sometimes there's a new, the maintainer package is a new version, and you think probably the bug is solved. And you also need to ask the original submitter if they still have the bug. Or somebody said, oh, I'm gonna do some text next weekend, and it's 2 years later, and I'm not sure they actually did the test they were saying they would do. So info were asked, and it feels like the bug is hanging. So in those cases, it's helpful sometimes to send an email to the person who said, I'm going to do something, or who needs to answer knowing if they still have the bug. And saying, hey, so that's a send a gentle ping. Like, you said you would test, or can you still reproduce the bug? And so that you can update the status of the bug on the bug tracker. It's okay, don't. It's good to wait like a good amount of time before bothering people about this kind of thing. Like, I usually wait 1 year, like I told you. Probably shorter might be good, but it's good also not to harass people, they have a life. So, sometimes the bugs have been tagged more info or won't fix for a long time. And the more info, the info is not given, or it's unlikely that somebody else wants this non-bug fixed. So, different teams have different policies, but most of them will be happy if you close the bugs that nobody's gonna do anything about. So, like, if the tag was tagged more info more than a year ago and nobody answered to give more info, or if a major release came out and probably the bug is fixed but the original submitter doesn't answer, then it's good to close them. In most cases, depending of the team. But it's good to ping them before you close, like give them a reasonable amount of time to try to test it again. Okay, we don't have the bottom of the page, but so the command to the command to close a bug is to number of bugs slash done at control. Maybe shouldn't have done that. And closing the bugs is kind of one of the most satisfying things to do. Like, sometimes I speak with my maintainer friends and I say, hey, I closed 25 bugs today. And they're kind of jealous because when you have to actually work on the bugs to close them, you can rarely fix 25 in 1 day. So it's kind of the perks of doing bug triaging. You, oh, a lot of, you know, less bugs on the bug tracker. I'm very efficient today. So, but don't close random stuff, but you know, when you find useless stuff to close, it feels good. So, where am I? Oh, okay, we missed the last sentence earlier. when trying to reproduce a bug, should pay particularly attention to the games team. You know, like people open bug reports against the games team, and then, oh no, you have to install a bunch of games to try to reproduce the bugs. So, you know, but for work. So you install a lot of games, and you try to see if they're buggy. So that's also another perk of triaging bugs. You get to try all the latest games. So another thing is when people open a bug and didn't check if there was already one open. So it ends up being two bugs for the same, two reports for the same bug. So it's good to merge them so that clearer. So the two bug reports must be on the same package with the same severity and the same state. Otherwise, you can't merge. So you have to send further commands to do that, like I showed before. And at the end, you tell the bug tracker to merge. So that we've seen. So you can okay, we can't really see the bug. So I was giving an example of my standard message I paste when I close a bug. And we don't see the end, but I'm going to do it from memory. So it says, hi, I'm closing this bug since it was tagged, more info for years without answer. If you still experience the issue, please feel free to reopen it or ask me to do it, because some people don't know how to reopen a bug that has been archived. So that's a very standard message. No, nothing, it's not very long. And it's very, so it's, but it's good to have a model so that you can just paste with niceness in it. If you're not sure about the bug report, you read through it and you're still not sure what to do. Because let's be clear, I don't always understand what the issue is. What you need to understand to triage is what the status of the bug report is. I triage bugs for the kernel. I don't understand anything about the kernel, like most human beings. But if you can, without understanding the bug report, you can understand if somebody asked for info and nobody provided it, or for example, if for the kernel, all the bug reports that were for the nouveau driver that is not supported anymore, it was possible to close them because nobody cared anymore. So you don't necessarily need to understand what the bug is about to do something about the bug report. But sometimes it's a bit more complicated, you're not sure. Just close the bug report, move to the next one. There's probably another one that's, you know, low branches, take the easy stuff. Because if you do something wrong or if you bother the maintainer to ask what should be done, then you're not really helping. You might be taking time from them that would be best invested somewhere else. So, small warning, there are some people who really don't like you touching their bug reports. I wish you not to encounter them. If you do, just either ignore them or ask the maintainers of the package you're triaging to step in and help, or you can also contact the anti-harassment team. But it's very rare, and most of Debian people are very nice people, and they'll be happy to cooperate and discuss with you. And bug triaging is fun and rewarding and easy. So those are the links to the things that are useful to 3H. So the first one is the first link is bad. I'll correct it. So the second one is how to 3H with all the different commands that are useful. The third one is server control, so where it reminds of all the different instructions you can send to server control, which is the way to interact with the bug report. The last one is about only closing, because you don't interact with control. You write to bug number done, so that's a different email destination. And so the idea was to have a workshop. So this was the explanation part, and now let's close some bugs, or sort them maybe.